Happy Friday, everybody, and a very, very happy birthday to Leslie, Chip's wife. That is why I'm here today.
Yep.
Because he's off celebrating with his wife today. So happy birthday, and also hi, Chip's mom. He'll be back next week. So just wanted to give a quick update. We had a very productive city council meeting this week. And for those who were unable to watch it, there were several items discussed. Some were regarding our city's unfunded pension liability, and our consultant provided mitigation options, including the development of a pension funding policy. So I know it sounds like a lot. It was a great presentation. I highly recommend that you can go back to our videos posted online and check it out. It's a very, very important part of the city organization, and you'll start to hear more and more about it regarding our upcoming budget process. We also were provided during this council meeting an update on the climate committee and discussion of state requirements for climate action. One more thing that was discussed was outdoor seating. Yep. And there was some approved amendment to the outdoor seating permits for three businesses, which were Sadie's, Barmel, and AW Shucks, right? Mm-hmm. And they were extended their closure to 1 a.m. with last service at 12:30 a.m. Also, one last thing was that there was an RFP for the Four Theater that was approved to go out. So stay tuned on all those great things. But again, our council meetings are posted online. The Climate Committee, their meetings are also online. So I highly recommend that you check that out. That's what I have.
Yeah, great. I thought the CalPERS presentation was very well done, very detailed and informative. Also, we have an ad hoc parklet meeting on Monday.
Okay.
So check the website if we forgot to add that. That's just ad-libbing a little bit. Couple things on the vaccinations. We're monitoring the county, their numbers, and their predictions for, well, they won't predict, but we can anticipate, hopefully, if our numbers continue to go down, moving into the red tier sometime this month, which is great. That means more openings, more opportunities for businesses, which is what we want. This past week, we participated in helping the Carmel Foundation.
Yes.
With administering vaccines to their members. They did nearly 400 vaccinations in about 7 hours, which is fantastic. Big shout out to Public Works, the police department, and our Carmel CERT team, who helped with the traffic control and getting some of the seniors into the building safely and helping to coordinate that. You know, I just want to give a shout out to our CERT team who, you know, looking back at 2019 and 20, over 1,100 volunteer hours.
Wow.
From that group.
That's wonderful.
Phenomenal.
That's amazing.
And again, to help out with situations like this with the vaccine, which we're starting to focus on, you know, we have a good idea how we're going to do it here. Should we have a community clinic? And we're learning a lot through the foundation. So it's a great partnership, something I'm really proud of. Our captains, Wanda Vollmer and Scott Smythe, along with our police officer, Rochelle Lightfoot, who coordinates the CERT team, just do a great job with that. So a big shout out to them.
That's great.
A little bit of weather coming up this weekend. We're expecting some higher winds than normal, maybe gusts up to 35 miles per hour. A little bit of rain tonight, but nothing severe, nothing major. We shouldn't have any flooding or clogged storm drains. So, but we'll monitor it, and Public Works is on duty to respond if needed.
Great.
That's all I have.
That's all you have. It's kind of short and sweet. But in closing, again, I just want to reiterate a great big thank you to all of our staff and all the volunteers who are just going above and beyond and providing such excellent customer service. We cannot thank you enough. We also understand how challenging it's been with city facilities closed to the public. And I just wanna again let you know that we are working on a reopening plan so that we can reopen safely to the public and also for our employees. So just know that that is definitely a priority for this organization so that we can have a safe reopening plan. So
absolutely.
On that note, just continue to be safe and
take good care.